So I've been associated and involved in the cybersecurity domain from 2016. I'm a published cybersecurity researcher, with my research being machine learning and security. And I've also worked with multiple researchers and professors all around the world to gain my goals as well. Currently, I'm working as a SOC analyst at Syracuse University, but I'm also pursuing a master's in cybersecurity. Right. So a few months ago, I was looking into how I can improve my skills in penetration testing and vulnerability assessment. And I was doing my research on the internet, and I came through CPENT by EC Council. The CPENT certification caught my attention because of two major elements: the 24-hour exam format and what coverage it covered in the security domain, as well as the report writing, which was extremely important for me, since cybersecurity is not just about hacking, but also making concise and, you know, valuable documents which can be given to higher up executives. And I found out about CPENT on the internet via LinkedIn and the website itself. After doing further research, I found more videos on YouTube, which really helped me, you know, get acclaimed and get used to the CPENT exam. So since I actually took up the task of learning for the CPENT exam, it was not easy just to start off. I've been preparing for this exam for more than 6 months now, and I've been putting in multiple hours and sleepless nights into this certification preparation. It has not been easy, and it takes a lot of time, effort, and a lot of patience, because some tasks and some tests might work in the first go and might not work in the second go. And there are some things which does not show up in, you know, the usual testing format. So it does take a lot of hard work and effort to actually prepare and do my research on the internet about the CPENT exam. It's not just about looking at the course content, but also doing a lot of personal study for this exam. And like I said, it took me 6 months of absolutely hard work and you know, just dedication to get this exam sorted out. Right. So the CPENT exam was one of the most difficult certifications I've ever undertaken in my whole career. And this is coming from a professional who's had experience with other certifications, not just once, but three to four different certifications. And this was clearly one of the most difficult ones. And this is entirely because of the exam structure and how the zones are laid out. There is a lot of content to cover in the five zones, which are not easily available or which are not easily accessible to you know, for any learning professional. The hardest part of the CPENT exam would definitely be the Active Directory zones, as well as pivoting, double pivoting. This is entirely because there are some best practices for the Active Directory zone which were actually implemented in the CPENT exam zones, and we were taught how to actually penetrate these systems even after the best practices were implemented. And the problem with pivoting and double pivoting is, though it is an old concept, it is well studied. There's not a lot of content available on the internet to actually study and research about this. So the only resources you have is a few blogs and few videos, absolutely no labs. And the only way you can actually practice is through the cyber range provided by CPENT and the instruction videos. So these are the two most difficult elements. On top of that, another difficult element of the exam was the binary exploitation and the binary research, which was required to pull off the attacks. That was definitely one of my weakest elements in the exam, but still there's a lot of content available on the internet for that. Active Directory and pivoting and double pivoting, that's not the case. So yeah, the three most attracting factor, or three most elements, the three elements which I liked the most was, first of all, the report making. So we know there are a lot of certifications which are available on the internet and by different vendors who actually have a similar setup, but they all of them might not need as a report element. But in my personal opinion, the report element is extremely important, because as a security domain, we need to be updating our higher up seniors and executives who might not understand the technical aspects of it. So making a report is extremely important, not just for executives, but also the technical team which might be developing the systems. Additionally, the second important thing, and the second thing which I liked the most, was the binary exploitation. The binary exploitation is again covered by multiple vendors, but it's not as elaborate as this is. And it's not just static analysis, but also dynamic analysis, which we have to perform in the certification. And on top of that, the last element was Active Directory. Since Active Directory is such a big element in enterprise systems right now, it is extremely important to be well-versed in the penetration testing of these systems. And Active Directory is actually the most used managed system provider in the whole world. So these are the three most important and three most liked features by me. So the lab experience for the CPENT as well as the LPT exam was absolutely great. We have two parts to this. One is the iLabs, and then there is the CPENT cyber range itself. So these two elements go hand in hand, and they really help you study for the and prepare for the well for the exam. With the iLabs, there are these labs which are included with the instruction videos. They are extremely important and helpful in understanding the concepts at a practical level, which is also correlated to the theory aspects. Then we move on to the cyber range. The cyber range is like a complete zone of the complete network which we get access to. It helps us practice our skills and sharpen our tools in the five zones which you are exposed to. And the cyber range is something which I've not experienced before, and it was a great setup, extremely stable and extremely reliable system. Though it is a shared system, I've never ever experienced anyone in the zone, and it was extremely stable. So since the tools are standard all around the cybersecurity industries, we use the same tools which we use in the industry as well as in the exam. So these tools are the first and foremost tools we use is Wireshark, Nmap and Nessus. So these are the tools which I used as a SOC analyst in my daily life as well, and which I had to also use in the exam. And it was extremely helpful to correlate and use the same tools because it helps me sharpen my day-to-day skills. And additionally, the things which I also learned from the exam and I'm trying to use as a SOC analyst is my Active Directory skills. Active Directory penetration testing is, like I already mentioned, is a big part in the enterprise systems, and it is the case even over here in my daily work life. So the penetration testing skills, which I gained from the certification, I'm also using as a SOC analyst. So these are the two major, these are the tools and the practices which I took from the certification I use in my daily life. CPENT has had a great benefit to my overall career and experience as a cybersecurity professional. Just being a student and being able to clear such a high level exam is a great added advantage to my resume, as now the companies have a standard and they know my skills in a specific domain. I've been reached out by multiple companies and organizations to either improve the cybersecurity posture or to just absolutely hire me. So it has definitely helped me in my career, and it has helped me expand the scope of the cybersecurity domain. And since it covers five different zones, especially the network penetration part is so in-depth, it has really helped me in adding more tools and custom tools into my portfolio, which I use in my day-to-day life. And this has extremely pushed forward my career in ways which I am yet to see, actually. I am experiencing already, and I'm sure it will be extremely beneficial for me in the future as well. Since I already mentioned, there are a lot of vendors which have a similar exam, but they do not have all the elements which I was looking for. CPENT definitely has all the elements, which includes the report writing as well as the different zones in the different domains of cybersecurity. The content which is available from the other vendors are not this organized, and the lab practices are also not this elaborate. So CPENT has over 150 labs for the certification, and additionally the cyber range really helps you develop and dive deep into the concepts. It's not just at a theoretical level, but at a practical hands-on level, which is not available by other vendors. And again, the report writing element is extremely important as a cybersecurity professional, and that's going to be the things which actually convert the technical aspects to a document which is relatable by the executives. And CPENT was the only certification which gave me such an experience. So the biggest advice I would give someone for preparing for the CPENT exam is to have patience and to prepare hard enough, and not just at the surface level, but actually dive deep into it. So if someone studies at the surface level, they will definitely not be able to get into the more elaborate attacks and more elaborate systems, especially the firewall zone, because the network is not flat. The network is not just protected by ACLs. These are real world firewalls which are implemented. They can be difficult and challenging at times, but if you really dive deep into it, you can do it. And on top of that, there's a lot of labs which might be available on the internet on vulnerable systems. A person needs to get used to these labs and actually practice hands-on for a consistent and for a standard amount of time. Only then they will be able to get into the CPENT exam and actually clear it. And for someone who's targeting the LPT, it's even more difficult, because getting CPENT is still okay, but then getting the 90% score is the difficult aspect. And they need to do a lot of research and actually learn about scripting and programming as well, because just having the openly available tools is not enough for this exam. You need to bring in your own tools, you need to bring in your own systems, and you need to bring in your own code, which is lightweight and concise, which can be run on different systems and systems which might not be stable. This is how a real world scenario looks like, and CPENT has done a great job in actually replicating it. So build your own tools, learn how to program, and do a lot of labs on the internet in addition to the labs provided by EC Council and CPENT exam.